What's going on, everyone? ZSC743 here, and this is part two of the hardest math skills motocross 2 challenge, which is getting first in every single career track. Last time we ended up finishing with, I believe it was open it up, so this part I'm going to go into rapid fire. If I'm able to do rapid fire, then I'll go into sunny side next. So we'll just get right into it. I will probably just go and try play with Derek 18 right now. And yeah, without further ado, let's just get right into it. Okay, so this track is a lot different than how I remembered it to be. They're actually doing the long jump now. You have enough speed to hit it all the way. Yeah, that's pretty cool. Bad. Oh, never done that before. That's pretty cool. Okay, so I ended up about 24 meters back. I think the furthest I was like 27 meters, so I did make up a little bit of time at the end. So I'll just try to go with that. That was interesting. Okay. I already know I'm not going to be able to win now. Ooh. I don't know if y'all saw that, but that was some pretty bad lag. Yeah, there's no way I can win at this point, so I'm just gonna. Never mind. Okay, so with the start, you want to try to get as low as possible. You can let off the gas slightly just to bring your front wheel back down. Okay, I'm still within right striking distance, so we'll see. We'll just finish this off just to get a time on the board. It'll probably be 30 fly, 32.9, a little bit faster than I thought. So 4 tenths exactly off, so that's not terrible actually. Good start. Missed the scrub, but I don't think that'll matter too much as long as I get everything else good.
Oh, no way! What? How did that win? What? I didn't even look like I was close. That didn't look close. What the fuck? Oh, Oh, let's go. That only took like 5 minutes. Let's go. Oh my God, what the hell? How did I win that? Look how far I'm a whole bike behind. What? How did I win that? That doesn't look like I won at all. What the fuck? All right. All right, I'll take it. I'll take it. First place, baby, with a tie. But all right. Okay. I wasn't expecting that at all. Normally in the past I've been showing just me for my first place, but let's check out the full top three actually, since it's as close as it is. I want to see from the replay standpoint if it looks like I'm ahead, because on mine I definitely lost that. What? A tied first place. That's rare too. That is not common at all. That is not common at all. That is awesome. In second place, it had quite the comeback. Ooh, that was a beautiful scrub. Good braking. Oh, he just seat bounced it. All right, from this perspective, it does look like I barely
had the edge. Just like microscopic, though. All right, let's go. First place. All right, so if I'm not mistaken, that is now 13 out of 144, or it's. Yeah, it's 13 out of 144. Let's go. All right, let's hop right into Sunnyside next. Let's just get right into it, baby. I'm feeling confident. I don't really remember this track much. Oh, it's the tap. That's right. I forgot about the tap. If I'm not mistaken, I think I was the first one to ever do the tap. But I don't remember. This one's going to be a little difficult because of that tap. But what I think I'll do last second, if you lean back, you get. If you just lean forward all the way, you'll get full forward momentum. But if you lean back last second, it'll actually keep you lower to the ground. But I still think that's too much speed. Yeah, that's still too much speed. So I have to brake, like let off the gas last second, or maybe brake last second. I think I'll try to brake. Yeah, braking's probably the way to do it. Oh, just a little bit off. Just a smidgen. Ooh, how'd that not hit? I'm a little surprised. How did that not make it? I broke a little too quick. Okay, there we go. Ooh. Actually got that well. All right, I was not that far off. I feel like it won't be too bad. I just need to get lap one good. I wonder if I can make it. I wonder if you can make this all the way first lap and then launch it. But I feel like even if you do, it's slower. Wait, I just had an idea, an epiphany. What if I need, this is something I need to test. I want to test if I can make this first lap all the way over. And then launch it, see what the comparison is. Because if with lap two, if I could just do the tap twice, I think that's a guaranteed win, right? Nice little tap, though. Did from quite the distance. Well, I'm not going to find out today. Ooh, actually, I could have attempted that. That's too far, for sure. Because it's on the downside, not going to get any pop that way. But it was a good scrimp. Yeah, because what I realized, what I can do with this tap as well, I can just press my front wheel in. So when I land right here, I can just land forward. With my front wheel kind of like this, and it would pop me up because if I don't unlock my front wheel, it'll pop me up a lot higher. And with that, I might be able to scrub it. Ooh, that was okay, but the tap wasn't. Okay, that's not bad. Yeah, let's attempt it. I was so close. But I feel like if you were ballsy enough to do it twice, it's definitely faster. So, I'm gonna attempt to be ballsy. If I want this win, I want it in such a dominating fashion. Because something like that would be insane. It's doable. I've done it in the past on believe it was, yeah, when Bike 11 first came out, it used to be a lot faster than what it is now. So they nerfed it. So the problem was with it when it first came out, the front wheel speed was discovered on Bike 10. So they kind of wanted to get rid of that when Bike 11 came out. So what they did is they reduced, like massively reduced, the speed you get if you aren't in a wheelie. And a lot of people did not like that, including I was one of them. However, old Bike 11 was like the speed of Bike 13 now. It was so much faster than what it is now if you are able to maintain a wheelie. So when that used to be a thing, that's when you would have enough speed to actually hit this tab properly. That's when I was experimenting with it. And in that time period with old Bike 11, that's when I did the tap on both flaps. I don't know if I still have that replay or not. Almost pulled it off. No, I jumped too far. Oh, that was it too. That well, clearly it wasn't it, but that could have been it. There we go. That's the word I was looking for. Like, it was a good tap and everything. It just went too far. Yeah, so the front flip is a little outdated because you can't really see where you're going. That's why I did like the lean stuff, so I kind of knew where I was. But it's a little unorthodox. So doing it the way that this MX Mark is doing, I will have to admit, it's definitely more consistent. This track is not that hard. It's just becoming annoying at this point. Like, this first jump is 90% of my restarts. Okay, definitely faster. Even with the case, I almost was faster. So 100% I'm going to be doing that. Of course, that means it's going to just take me longer. If I have the opportunity, I'll go for it. If obviously, if I'm unable to do it, I'm not going to force it. Yes! Finally! Finally! Oh my God, that took so long for no reason. Oh, the pain and agony is finally over. And boom! Finally, it's over. It's over. The double tap is over. And I was about to get so irritated if I did it both times and still lost. But thank God, it's over. Not the 32s, but yeah. Oh my God. All right, now to keep traditions alive, let's check out my time against me in former first place, even though kind of checked it, but you can see from his perspective. I want to point this out. I think it's funny. I said way early on that his method is a lot more consistent, but I kept sticking with mine. That just shows how stubborn I am. If I'm used to something, I'm just gonna keep with it, even though it's either slower or not as consistent. If it's something that I'm accustomed to, I'm just gonna keep at it. Yeah, look at the comeback. I had a thought way early on, and it actually was true. So that's awesome. Finally got this one. And with that, that would be 14 out of 144. So I'm about, in technicalities, I'm 10% of the way there, which is just great. And for the rest of the novice division, that's going to wait until part three. I think two tracks apart is good, unless I can get it through like super quick. But if I come across one that takes me a while, I'm just going to do two. But with that, thank you guys so much for watching. And stay tuned for part three, where we will be attempting Swap City first. So yeah, with that, thank you guys once again for watching. And I will see y'all in part three.